This is Jeremy Harrelson with Monster Training, day 4 of the Bench Press Challenge with the Book of Methods from the Bulgarians. Today's the most easiest workout for me will be the static holds. The purpose of static holds is picking up heavy weight, bringing it off, and just getting your body used to being up under heavy weight. Let's go ahead and get started. Just all the way out, 10 second hold. This weight, you want to go all the way up to, you can't even bring it off and try to hold it. The modified version of this is the pin press. Pin press move from different angles to, depending on the weight you're lifting in the day it is in the process. Always bleed if you can get up under heavy weight. Get your body used to it, your body will evolve. Eventually you'll be able to bench it, which is 100% true. Won't do many sets this today due to timing issues. Second hold. Probably need to go a little heavier. All my plates are different sizes. There's a 45, but a little small for some reason. The weights that are developing now, the ones I'm making now, the 45s are like that thick. I'm like, I don't know how you would fit all of them on a bar. But to most people, this workout's a lot harder than what you would think it would be. Yes. A little over 600 pounds on her now. But the beginning process is the static hold. So you come out, you get used to holding the weight. Then you move on to the static hold in the squat rack. What you would do is you would place the pins high and you would come down this much, touch the pin, and every week you would come down a little lower with the pins to your chest. And that is the fastest way to get stronger as far as the Book of Methods. The only problem with that is, even though we know about the theory of evolution, the body evolves, but if you don't do that one all the time, what happens is you kind of lose strength, or even worse, you get injury. The injury is because you have no base. You have to work out to be able to maintain that strength. You can get strong, but over a long period of time, you won't be able to maintain it. It just starts going away. I'm gonna go a little bit heavier, not much heavier, but I don't want to bend my bar doing freaking static holes. Maybe 10, 20, 30 pounds, something. I don't know if I got any more. This workout method is very important to me and a lot of other people that work out by themselves. A lot of times with heavy weight, you got to be able to bring it off. Not all the time do you always have a spotter. So if you want to be able to bench 400 or 500 pounds, first plateau or first thing you got to beat is you got to be able to bring the weight off yourself. I mean, you could be a 400-pound guy, and you could do push-ups, which is equivalent to probably 350, 360. But you can't bench 360 because you can't bring it off. So this is one way you can get your strength up to be able to bring the weight off the rack. If I can even bring this off, that's 700-something damn pounds. Yeah, that's pushing it right there. I mean, even with my gloves on, I can feel the bar flexing. And that's a 300-pound, well, that's a $300 bar. So, Texas bar, Texas. Must be max capacity, 1,000-something pounds, some shit. I don't trust it. This has been Jeremy Harrelson with Bench Press Challenge, Day 4, Book of Methods. Try them. I mean,